back. We're still in IMS Prussia Cove. Mentally, we can't be in Cornwall this year for obvious reasons, but luckily, firma Bechstein is hosting us and hosting some online lessons with participants that were selected to be in Cornwall for the IMS Prussia Cove seminar. And Yundi will play the Chopin Sonata Opus 35, first movement. If you're surprised that we're unmasked, it is because at Bechstein everything is possible, including testing. So we've been tested and we're very negative, which is the new positive. So you play and then we talk.
Thank you.
enough for me. So generally, the impression is it on enough on the substance of the thing, or is the substance clear of the piece or of the composition? Even if I forget that it's by blessed Chopin, so all bets are off. It's Chopin. So what could they go? But in another way, so if this is not by Chopin, but just simply a good piece, then things happen that we are so used to now. Says, well, you know, Chopin is approximately like that. But then, if we look in the score, is it quite like that? So let's look with all your advantages. The surface of the tarmac. So what do I mean? That this is already so for me perhaps much more conflicted and much more agitato than this. So why is not making that impression? Perhaps that the pedal is so maybe too generic, and maybe this is perhaps too similar. But we will look at it. Let's start again, and I so try to interfere, and then you can forget the interferences afterwards, or not. It was totally your choice. I'm confused that, so again, it's like every other piece that we've heard today. They are in very different ways, or sometimes in similar ways, very daring. And I think this is one of the top daring ones. And even, yeah, no, so no, well, simply so, but also perhaps, it could be in so many keys, and so it's rather surprising that this is so. It's a B flat minor sonata, and this terrible truth of where he has led us is coming out very quickly. This so already this is a terrible conflict, you know, and a terrible let down in the best sense, and also that this is a D flat, and the E natural is okay, this is still possible, and then the C sharps and G sharps, and the and for me this was a bit so peaceful that, you know, speak German, or you do speak German. Yeah, so this is very much a doch. You know, this is doch B flat minor. But if this doesn't shock us already as a stab in the heart, this is then perhaps not a good use of this bullet. Yeah? One more time? What were you doing before you were playing? No, I think this is okay. Harmony is okay. The bass is good before. As you wish. And sorry, I guess I would also not overlook that essentially. Three of these pitches. For me, I understand it's proper to play a resolution softer, but you are. Idea. here, but the this is already also, if this is a grave with a alla breve time, so what is the time? So I guess the other question of why Chopin and why is this okay, that I'm so used to hearing this without a particular time that would be expected if this was, I don't know. So there we expect, well, some time and some maestro. But this is Chopin, so it's a bit then. Now, anytime. And I guess for you, a question of, or is it? Because there is a. Which voice is where, and what is the resonance? And then there's a. Then it's octaves, yeah? Not a. Then there's a single note, and this is not an octave, yeah? Obviously wonderful. He cuts the pedal before, because you play. It's not implied. It's not. Don't you think that there is a not an exhalation. There is an inhalation. Or a ventilation, rather. There's good ventilation here, I can see. There's a lot very nice on the ceiling. And by the way, I think, well, this is the danger of editions in Mr. Corto. I don't know if you really need to change your finger. This is. Incidentally, sorry about the minute details, but it doesn't help for the shock effect that you do. Then every so grandmother and great grandmother knows that you're about to do something, but. That this should be like this, already running for 24 hours, this machine before. Not sure that how the cylinders of this engine work, the pistons. Because you play this, I hear okay, but. And he's not a very unclassical composer, not very far from Mozart, so these two-note slurs, this is, what does it tell us? Well, there's obviously, if it's two notes under slur, it's two, but what does it do to the first note under the slur? Yes, it's a bit more emphasized, and even so possibly timing is not the same, they're not exactly in the same rhythmic value. So there is a, it's really, I think, quite like pistons, but maybe it's not a cold machine, it's a very hot machine. And then he kind of shows the machine so the camera zooms in and out. And then comes the next entry. Partly it's his fault, but basically it's not his fault at all. But this pedal contraption, it makes the thing, so I know it says pedal, but it makes the thing much more calm and sort of stewy with the but incidentally, especially growing up in Paris, have you tried some of these old pleyels and erars? Chopin's time. So the thing is in some way much more brittle and much more noisy, and even with pedal, that there's a lot of the and the pedal is mostly like this. It's not a so this wind machine effect, this comes with a late 20th century pianos. But as a defense of my saying that perhaps the pedal is not so deep that we and also each time there is an opening there, this so sticks its head in, and also that down, not down, so it's very melodramatically conflicted, like silent movies. But you're a bit so tirombororombirombororo, so it's a bit for me anti-agitato. So I would feel that each one I'm playing in a slightly different place, not spinning in the same. So somebody will rightfully complain that this is not good if it's two times. Even if you do some sort of manipulation, but not twice the same. So I guess we come to the point that maybe they all look the same on the printed page, but that there some are quicker and some are slower of this. So of course this is both obviously slow and exaggerated, but that they're not the same is not exaggerated. Yeah. It might be really true. So I worry, and
or I want to try to
propose for you not to be relying. It seems that you want to achieve the agitato by a general crescendo in diminuendo in that. But it
doesn't produce the agitato.
The agitato is produced by the individual cells of this, so being placed in such a way. So it could be piano or forte. But even this so-called hairpin, and we know in Beethoven, Schubert, but also we know in Chopin that this very well means that a certain timing, rather than that.
You can if you want to be so entertaining
with dynamics, but the
thing doesn't depend on it.
The thing very much depends on the hyperventilation. So it's literally what then they write in reviews: breathless, breathless. So but this is actually breathless, not like the newspaper review. Yeah, so coraggio. Yeah, by the way, you're very welcome to try absolutely not the Rio speed if you want the. My impression also that you are not, for you, the closing of the sound before the rest is a bit so an automatic thing. You stop playing and then stop. But how does this finish? And by the way, the legato also possibly means that you won't get arrested for some holding, and even I think the pedal. Now we get to another favorite of clavier, pedagog, the finger pedal, but there's something true about it. You look disappointed. after years of having good articulation. No, it's okay. But it's better, believe me, than a general sauce. Accelerando that you play so they're speaking notes to the end, because you then start playing a figuration. I'm concerned that so which alien would know that in fact Chopin really wrote tara tarara. Because you take the pedal and in fact it sounds say yada. One doesn't hear the rest at all. And I understand that there's a certain contradiction, or not a contradiction, but a certain concern that, oh, he writes pedal, and ah, he writes the pause. But I don't think the pause should be on the losing end of this equation. And the pedal is just essentially saying, so there should be some acoustic, some resonance of the. But we should hear that it's not. Because otherwise, it's every time the mouth is open of this figure. But I understand it's not easy to change or to try changing, but but I think hands are used to so a relative comfort of a comfort of
wood pianist, so work,
but it's uncomfortable, should be. So then he understands that this has to be also varied. Huh? So what can I be useful with? Can I say that perhaps also when you're at home, that you should try to de-automatize the time of the resolution, that, you know, because this is very habitually automatic seems, that it comes whenever it comes after the first note. But what would be nice is if you had at your disposal 99 gradations of but when it comes very quick and very soon, that it's on purpose, it's not a figuration in the hand. So it's pronounced.
Okay.
I could say that you don't, for my taste, pronounce the second note. So it comes as a certain result of the first note, but not a tia 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 tia. Second note. I don't think this is so abgespielt quick. Two notes. Yeah. Maybe. Yeah. This is also one hears it regularly. The giving up is very quick. They say, okay. So it's, even if one believes, I don't remember if this is Cortot or this is Chopin, but it's probably not bad. It's not on the first measure, the piano, but on the second. Stranger. I think this is a appoggiatura. One more time. It's interesting. This makes an appearance with you. This good, but where does it come from? It comes. Of the voice. So the bass plays a function from before. And I guess for me it sounds a bit too banal with so I guess they're also sighing. So, sorry, for me, this one is very soon, too soon, because this one has its own tension. Let's not forget the hyperventilation, a favorite thing here. One more time. And a bigger there. The four voice thing it is, because I hear a bit so everything given for the better life of the top voice, but is before, and also this one goes, and this is another entrance, don't you think? It's not the Chopin didn't write the melody. Polyphony that one. Yes. Yes. And I have a feeling that this so-called accompaniment is having a more interesting life for itself. This that each, depending on the situation, it reacts each time. Aha! So, you know. he liked Mozart, Mr. Chopin, he liked Bellini, and he, but he also, so Bach and this whole so polyphonic thing is, anyway, it's very polyphonic music. And it's also, you could see that this would appeal or be very understandable for Schumann, because there is a certain kind of manic quality of obsessiveness of that. It's not very far from. So, yeah. Yes, but if you just do a crescendo in the middle of the bar, then somebody will kill me. So I don't mean. It's not, again, not dependent on crescendo, depending on this pronunciation. In balance with, because now of course one could say, well, it's too much of this. Sure that it's such a straight continuation, because you understand what I mean? That it's not and he even doesn't slur it like this. Interesting grouping possibilities there, less so not so expected. By the way, I have a feeling that Mr. Rachmaninoff was quite taken with this when he wrote. So it's exactly the same. So also, and some more, and how it's built is very related. Of course, you know the recording of Rachmaninoff playing this, which is a towering example. So from anywhere here. It's good. This is maybe the good thing with Chopin, where on one hand it's so terribly romantic, but on the other hand that you see that this was so a very clear thinking individual, and especially a composer with certain clearly worked out strategies of how to spin this thing out. So it's not all in a sort of dream about George Sand. But when there's more notes, I think there's more, in a good sense struggle to pronounce them, because you play and anyway, I think this, so he had to write 4 eighth notes and then 6 tuplets in quarters, but I think it's again a certain speaking. So it's not a 8th note, 6 tuplets. So if you are used to do a little bit of the octavisierung, I understand it feels good, but I think it's so, I could imagine that it's so agitato now in a different way, in this, so I am singing my chest out, that it even cannot continue succeeding as a melody anymore, so there's only sort of the feeling without the melody. Cannot continue getting louder, so it even is soft. It's out of the abundance of feeling, because very often it sounds like A, people start, a pianist starts something new, and now, so now, jetzt ein bisschen dirigieren, and secondly, that it seems that, okay, he had good inspiration for the tune, and then there's a bit of a lapse of inspiration, but I think he was so. And it's very cleverly getting ready for. So it's he's so closing the seams. So the thing will make an exposition. So you want to do a even he writes for Sander for you. Do you see somewhere it says that it's a particularly short note? Me neither. Also, I don't see that it's slurred with pedal, especially this is. All of them are in some way not flippant. Not sure this is a recipe to the soul of the piece. And the listener, I don't hear a singer playing. It's not quite yet. Could you play the soft ones, so-called soft, the piano, like it's even more terribly affecting you? Because the impression is that so forte, okay, I'll do ask the favor, but then it's piano from shivering that this is such a harmony. My God. this, I'm sure, I already said this about Mozart, but I'm sure true with Chopin, and I think with most of composers, I think he's very proud of this modulation, because this is not something that every other person on the Parisian street was modulating like, so so I'm sure when Liszt came over to here, and he was like, but you're a bit so, it would be anything. Still, even today, sounds quite adventurous. It's not very far from Bartok. Then this, so by the way, do you know the Strauss burlesque for piano and orchestra? Because the party shtick of this is the. So that from a diminished chord you could modulate anywhere. So anywhere. So this is one of these moments where Chopin does the same thing. Where is this going to modulate? Given at all, but the and then it so it's rather head spinning in the best sense. But if you play it, if you play it like, well, this road has been traveled by millions of piano pilgrims, then it's a bit so buried. Yeah, so yeah, from here. Then finally, when he figures out his way out of this modulation, which was not a given, then it's so hallelujah. So for me, you play a bit easy, and also and only here. So before, we cannot really have a G natural. So don't play it generally. Maybe I have a big hand, but I would consider. No, you don't need to. You don't need to do this. But then. That we don't just hear the octave, but we hear. Example, so maybe it's something to say that be careful or watch. Quasi dissolving, like ta-ra, that you play like here,
that you play them
a bit so like an automatic afterthought. But ta-ra-ra, it's still there pronounced, and it's not ya-da-da, ta-da-da, ta-ta-ta. This is disturbing. One more time. What happens if we, it's not very different from Stravinsky, so you know that, so he shifts it by one, so what happens then? Surprised. I think this is the stop and go in a good sense. This is a sudden so restart. It's not a. This we didn't have before. So, also in this so-called masterclass situation, so what can be left with you that's useful? One of the simple left useful things is that to see which one is which one then is not like the previous, which is very often the case. So, but this is very. But you play too similar. You play. So without this shift, it wouldn't be possible to continue for him. So you cannot overlook it. Yeah, from. But you're not playing. This is it's an octave because it's double bass and cello, but it's not now that the motion is different, that the character of the motif is different. It's not a, it's agitated, but it's not a ticket. And this is so, look, he really goes out of out of the frame, tries to, and so it falls back into failure. In the best sense. By the way, this is obviously clearly so Tchaikovsky is then inspired by this. So even by this kind of sequencing. So very heartbreaking from me. Thank you. are pauses that he writes so intently. Legato pedal, practically, but the new harmony is new pedal, and there's a ventilation before. It's not a. Scared from such bass, gigantic basses, and we lost the balance with the. So, if we go from somewhere. But there's other possibilities, like not all the way. This is also with pedal, but it's so barely up. Then one hears even some of the tatara, but you open it very much. And then we're sort of in a big sinking ship. This is a better picture. Yes, so an innocent observer could imagine that this will go into B flat. No. So this is another so B flat that I had in store for us. It's a bit watched recently with my kids, the Indiana Jones, and you know when he goes into one of these so ancient tunnels that contain the treasure, and then so then these spikes and these arrows, and this starts to go through the floor, and this stone falls from the top. So this is like the Indiana Jones. So it's out of the sequence, which you remember where that comes from? Where does this come from? Yes, and even more, I think, from Hallelujah. But now it's so not so Hallelujah. It's more, much more desperate. It's more like a SOS. Yes, two voices. not just the sorry, soon we have to leave anyway because our hosts have let us stay anyway much longer because I am Verspätung, and so it accumulates. So it's plus 10 minutes, plus 5 minutes, and then the train is cancelled. But let's hear the very end, please. So wherever you want, maybe. Wherever. Let's do from here. There's a. Yes. Let's have the result that you don't play the staccato because they're not. Carefully, that not so much whatever moves is important. Yeah, no, this is a terrible breakthrough. This is so that already the peasants are bursting into the estate and are about to burn the whole thing down. So don't wait. We are coming. We shall burn the villa down, okay? Coming with buckets of water, they're more with sticks. There's no pedal, even for Corto and for Chopin. And here, then you start playing now a bit faster. Again, the peasants that are burning the estate down, they are ruthless, but they have the goal of triumph. So I think it can continue strettoing, but not in a way that's unrelated to what just came before. If you want to take it to the extreme, then it drives into the wall. And I imagine also that there's not the grand pedal, because Paderewski did this, when he did it, maybe it was okay, but because the whole thing remains breathless. Yeah, one more time. That it becomes just so operetta, a bit cheap, that this you cannot afford because you play it. It cannot be this. It's not that. It's each time you push a bit more. And then you want to say, they burned the villa down and they sat at the dining table and had themselves a fine dinner. Because you do it. Because somewhere you were taught it's a noble sound, a bit more time, and to do something. But why wait? I think so, for me more so. I think it's a clearer piece in some way. It's a much more extreme piece in many ways. And just because it's from the Romantic age doesn't mean that the pedal is so generously dispensed, because we're generous people, especially on modern pianos. But this is not only to do with the pianos, but so especially, I guess you could say really in anything, but especially in the so-called sonatas of his, then this is very strategic music, and at the same time very emotionally in distress. And so the first version for me was not clear strategically and not in distress. Mm-hmm. And the distress has a lot of variety, obviously. So, ta ta ti ra ra, or ta ra ta ra ti ra ta ra ti ra ta ra ti ra ta ta ra. Yeah? Okay, so it's a lifelong journey with this piece, and good luck. So, if there's anybody still out there in cyberspace, thank you very much. This was IMS Prussia Cove. And if not, well, hopefully you're asleep or doing something better. And thank you to Bechstein.